The mother provides most of the care to infants and juveniles, feeding, grooming, and socializing them. Tool use has also been observed in some gorilla populations, and the mother would teach this as well. The silverback is charged with the protection of his offspring and females from other silverbacks. Young blackback males within the group, generally his sons, may help him fend off other silverbacks who challenge his position. But as the blackback males mature, they become a threat to the silverback's dominance and are usually driven off between the ages of 11 and 13. They then go in search of their own group, either by taking over a group or joining up with individual young females from several different groups. Females usually leave at about age 10, but they will immediately join a young male or an established group, whereas males may spend several years living alone. Males generally do not get the opportunity to mate until they are about 15 years old. Dog breeding can be a highly controversial topic. Some animal lovers are hooked on a breed and will shell out big bucks for the perfect purebred. Others are adamantly against breeding with so many dogs available in shelters and rescue groups. Breeding used to be highly functional. A shepherd breeds only the best herding dogs, or a hunter breeds the dogs with the best instincts. But with dogs now serving more of a companion role in society, many prospective pet parents are simply looking for specific features in their puppy, whether it's a purebred or designer mix. Just how did we get to where the look of a dog is potentially more important than his function? We'll explore the hows and why of dog breeding and look back on the centuries of history that got us here.